Cannot believe another year is pretty much done. I have a few more things to make this year that I'm sure I will share with you later. But this year I've made a lot and I wanted to look back on the year and kind of like a visual scrapbook, put everything together, see what I've learned, how much I've grown, what I still want to grow in, what I'm looking forward to. I really think there's a lot of value in doing this, and I hope that you do it for yourself as well. And I would love to see what you've made, what your favorite thing that you've made this year is. You can comment below, tag me on Instagram. I would love to celebrate our makes together. Just celebrating the fact that you took the time to make something, that you took the time to slow down. I was looking back a little bit on my plans, what I thought I was gonna make, the fabric that I bought, the patterns that I thought I was going to do, and a lot of them did not work out. Or I didn't do them, or I just realized, I wanted to change a lot of things to it, or something came up and I wanted to make something different. But I do think that plans are powerful, so stay tuned because I have some plans for next year that I'm excited to share with you. And personally, this was a bumpy year for our family. It was not a normal year in the slightest, and so I really think that having the scrapbook of all of these makes really represents the year. I think it even is like a timestamp that I can look back on and be like, oh, I remember when I was making this and the memories that came up and what I was processing and how that was just a restful place for me to turn to when I needed that quiet place to go to, or I needed to just bring the sewing machine into our dining room and sew. And again, I'm just reminded of the gift of creating and how life-giving it is to do something that you enjoy and practice and keep improving. And that is a big takeaway from the year, is to continue to work at things and to continue to cultivate a craft and continue to learn, because I clearly do not know everything. And I love the process of learning something new and getting a little bit better day by day, practice by practice. I was trying to think about it, and I don't know if I have a favorite make from this year, but looking back at all of the projects that I did, it does stand out to me some things that I want to continue to grow in, learn, and even make more of a priority next year as I'm making. And one of those things is smocking. I think it's something that I just keep coming back to. I think I keep coming back to because I'm just like, I have so much to learn, and there's so many possibilities with it, and it's such a fun craft that once you kind of get it to a point, you can sit on the couch and enjoy a cup of tea while you're adding the embroidery to it and seeing this like age-old craft in a modern way and kind of seeing new ideas and possibilities to be had with smocking. So that's definitely something I want to continue next year. I would like to smock things for myself. I don't think it would be as involved as like a child's project because there's just a lot more fabric, and so smocking smaller portions of a dress I think would add a really nice detail. So that is something I am looking forward to carrying into the new year. And I just look at all the things that these projects encompass and show me the reward that comes with it, not only to myself, but how it gets to close my family in a unique way and see my daughter light up when she gets to try on something that I made for her and give me constructive criticism, which makes me better, I think. Or I know it makes me better. She has just grown into such a fun personality that I feel like we get to work on these projects together in a sense and kind of share a vision, and a lot of times our visions clash. But that has been fun to navigate. So for next year, you can stay tuned because I have some plans for the next year and I have a resource for you to help plan out your year of making and really hone in on your own creative style and learn in some unique ways. So thank you for being here. I am just immensely grateful for this community, how you have supported this channel. You've supported me and our family, and you have helped us grow. You've helped me grow as a person. You've inspired me, and I'm just beyond grateful. So I'm excited to keep making together, see what you've created, and see what next year holds and how we can grow together in the pursuits that fill us up.